trainer kit. Order code is 33503. So this is the trainer kit. This is fixed and variable DC power supply. This first block, there is plus 12 volt fixed DC power supply and 0 to 20 volt variable power supply. With the help of this switch, we can select fixed or variable power supply. Next is minus 12 volt fixed power supply and 0 to 20 volt variable power supply. With this switch, we can select the fixed and variable power supply. Next block is plus minus 5 volt fixed DC power supply. The fourth block is for AC power supply, 10 volt and 5 volt. Next is, this is for switch, these two block 5 and 6. This is for continuity tester, this is the buzzer. Here this block is the data switches to give logic 0 or logic 1. This is the function generator block. With the help of this knob, we can select sine wave, triangular wave, square wave or pulse. With the help of this knob, we can select the frequency range. With the help of this knob, we can select the level of amplitude. Here, these are the potentiometer block. This is potentiometer 1K, this is 22K, this is 47K. This is the logic indicators to show the output status of the circuit. This is the inbuilt digital panel meter. With the help of this switch, we can select 20 volt. We can select voltmeter whose range is 20 volt, or we can select current meter which range is 200 milliampere. This is the bar graph block. This is here, these three are also potentiometer. This is the connecting terminals. This is a variable frequency. We can give 1 hertz to 10 hertz. And this is the clock generator block. Here we can give 1 hertz or 100 hertz. This is the speaker block. There are two blocks for pulsar switch. With the help of this switch, we can give manual pulse to the circuit. This is the logic probe block and this is the BCD to 7 segment block. This, with the help of this block, we can select CMOS or TTL. With this kit, this accessories box is included. Here the different types of ICs, capacitors, resistors and diodes. All the components are included which we are going to need to perform all the experiments. And this is the user manual and patch cards. These all are included in this kit. To perform the experiments, we will need an oscilloscope and multimeter. Experiment is to verify the truth table of NAND gate. So this is a NAND gate IC7400. Now we will connect plus 5 volt power supply here and ground to here. Now we will give input to pin number 1 and pin number 2, and we will observe the output at pin number 3. Before that, we will connect the power supply to pin number 14 and ground to pin number 7. Now turn on the kit. So first, we can see that our input is 00 and the output is 1. Now I am giving 01, the output is still 1. Now I am giving 10, the output is 1. And now I am giving 00, and the output is 0. So this is the truth table of NAND gate. Experiment is 4-bit binary up counter. For this, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. So for this, we are going to need two 7476 ICs. This is the 7476 ICs. Now first, we will connect the power supply here and ground here. सॉरी, नाउ कनेक्ट प्लस सॉरी कनेक्ट पिन नंबर 5 टू द पावर सप्लाई एंड पिन नंबर 13 टू ग्राउंड. Connect pin number 13 to ground. Now we will make this connection. This PR input will connect this PR input 27 and 27 these pins to the power supply, that is plus 5 volt. So connect 2 and 7 pin of both ICs to power supply. Now we will make this connection. We will short this two terminal 4 to 16 and we will connect it to plus 5 volt. Similarly, we will short this two terminal 9 to 12 and we will connect it to plus 5 volt. Same will go for the second IC. So connect 4 and 16 like this. Connect it to power supply block. Again we will connect 9 and 12 and we will connect it to power supply block. For the second IC we will do the same. Connect 4, short 4 and 16 and connect it to plus 5 volt, that is the power supply. And short 9 and 12 and connect it to power supply. After that we will connect this pulsar with pin number 1 of the first ICs. This is the, we are giving clock input to pin number 1. Now we will connect the output. So first for this we will short terminal 15, sorry pin number 15 and 6. And we will connect it to output Q0. Now we will short pin number 11 and 1, pin number 11 of second ICs and pin number 11 of first IC and pin number 1 of second IC, and we will connect output Q1 to any of the IC, that is we can connect it to pin number 11 and also we can connect it to pin number 1 as we have short pin number 11 and 1. Now again we will short pin number 15 and pin number 6 of the second IC, and we will take our output Q2 from here. And we will connect output Q3 to pin number 11 of second IC. Now we will connect the clear input, that is, we will connect pin number 3 to pin number 8 of the first IC. And then again from pin number 8 we will connect pin number 3 of second IC, and again we will short pin number 3 and pin number 8 of second IC. And from pin number 8 we will take this, where this is the clear input. So whenever we want to reset it, whenever we want to reset the counter, we will touch this momentarily to ground and like this, and the counter will be reset. Now we will verify the truth table. And this is the truth table of 4-bit binary of counter that we are going to verify. So turn on the key. This is all 1-1. By using the clear, touch it momentarily in ground to reset the counter. Now the counter is all the values are 0 0 0 9. Now give this pulsar sweep and we can see that it is counting like this. Again to reset, touch it to the ground and it will be reset. This experiment is study of full wave bridge rectifier. So for this we are going to build this connection here. So for this we are going to need 4 diodes. So this is the anode of the diode and this is the cathode. So connect it like this in the breadboard. Now we will take another diode. So the cathode of this diode, this is the D1. So the cathode of this diode will be connected with the anode of this diode. So connect it like this. This is D2. Now cathode of this diode, that is cathode of this diode D2, will be connected with the cathode of D4. So connect it like this, and now we will connect the last diode, that is it will be connected like this. This is D3, so anode of D1 will be connected with the anode of D3. Now we are going to need a resistor 1K. And we will connect it this junction, that is D2 and D4, we'll connect this at this junction. So connect it like this. Now we will give 0 volt, sorry, yes, we will give 0 volt to this D3, to this junction D3 and D4. We will give 10 volt AC to this D1 and D2. So connect it here. Connect this side of the resistor to 0 volt. That is here. Now we will observe the full wave, rectified waveform at terminal 3 and 4, that is across this resistor. So sorry, connect the other end of the resistor to this junction D1 and D3. Now connect the negative terminal of the CRO here and we can see the full wave rectifier waveform. Our next experiment is to study 4-bit serial input parallel output shift register. So for this we are going to build this connection here. We will need 2 7474 ICs. So first connect the ground and the power supply plus 5 volt. Keep the switch in TTL mode. Now we will connect pin number 14 of both the ICs to plus 5 volt power supply and pin number 7 to ground. This is pin number 7, we will connect it to ground. Now we will give serial input to pin number 2 of the first IC. Serial, connect the serial input to data switch and give it to pin number 2. Now we will give clock pulse input to pin number 3, 11 of first IC and pin number 3 and 11 of second IC. So first we will connect these ICs. So first I will short this terminal. This is pin number 3. Short this to pin number 11. Again, from pin number 11, short it to pin number 3, and from pin number 3, we will short pin number 11 again. Now connect the clock pulse input to, we can connect it to any of the input, so I am connected it to pin number 3 of the first IC. Now we will connect the output, that is first we will short pin number 5 and 12, then we will short pin number 9 and 2, and then we will short 5 and 12 again. So from 5 and 12 we will take output A. So first short pin number 5, this is 5 and 12, and we will take an output from this junction. This is 12, this is output A. Now again we will take pin number 9, this is pin number 9 of the first IC, and we will short it to pin number 2 of second IC. Now we will connect output B from here. Now again we will connect pin number 5 of the second IC, and we will short it to pin number 12 of second IC. And we take output C from here. And we will connect pin number 9 of the second IC to output D. 8, 9. So this is the pin number 9. We will connect. We have connected it to the left. Output D. Now here pin 1 and 13 of first IC, and again pin 1 and 13 of second ICs are all connected together, and we need to connect it to clear the, connect it to the ground to clear the input. So connect pin number 1, we will short this pin. So pin number 1 and 13, again short it to pin number 1 of the second IC. Again I am shorting pin number 1 of the second IC to pin number 13 of the second IC. From this now take out a connection, this one, and we will use this to clear the input by touch this to ground momentarily. So the circuit diagram is complete. Now we are going to verify the truth table.
So we will going to verify this truth table here. This is the truth table of 4 bit serial in parallel out of parallel out shift register. So first select this switch in TTL mode. Now turn on the key. This is the clear input. So by touch it momentarily to ground, and we can see that the register is reset to 0. Now give the manual pulsar. Sorry, this is also in 0. So reset it to 0.
Now give manual pulsar. Again, 0. Touch it to ground to reset is 0. Give the serial input. Experiment is application of XOR gate as a binary word comparator. For this, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. For this experiment, we will need 17486. This is 7486, 17404IC, and 17420IC. So first, we will give the input. So this is the X0 input which we are going to give at pin number 10 of this IC. Now we will give input Y0 to pin number 9 of this IC. Now X1 to pin number 5 and Y1 to pin number 4. Now we will give X2 to pin number 2 and X1 to pin number 1. Now we will give X3 to pin number 13 and Y3 to pin number 12. Now we will take the output of this pin and we will connect it with this 7404IC. So connect pin number 8 of this first IC with the input of 7404, that is pin number 5. Now we will connect pin number 6 of this IC to pin number 9 of the second IC. Now we will connect pin number 3 with pin number 11 of this IC. And now we will connect pin number 11 of this IC with pin number 3 of this IC. Connect this through pin number 3. Now we will connect pin number 4 to pin number 4 of 7420 and pin number 10 to pin number 5 of 7420. Pin number 8 will be connected with pin number 1 of 7420 and pin number 6 will be connected with pin number 2 of 7420. Now we will connect the output at pin number 6 of 7420. Now connect the power supply to pin number 14 of all the ICs and pin number 7 to ground of all the ICs, and after that we will verify the truth table. We are going to verify this truth table here. So here, when all the inputs are 0,
when all the inputs are zero, the output Z is also zero. Now, as I'm giving 1 to all the inputs, the output Z is also 1. Now, I am giving X 1 1, X 0 1, and Y 2 1, and we can see that the output is also 1. Like this, you can verify the rest of the truth table, which is this one. Our next experiment is study of transistor shunt voltage regulator. This is the circuit diagram that we are going to build. So first we will connect 390 ohm resistor. So this is a 390 ohm resistor. Connect it like this. Now we will connect this Zener diode with the resistor. So connect the Zener diode like this. This is the cathode part and this is the anode part. Now we will connect these two 20 ohm resistor across this resistor 390. We will connect this resistor here. So connect this resistor like this. Now we will connect this transistor from here to here. So this is the collector of the transistor. So this is base, this is emitter. So connect it. Like this, the emitter will be connected with this 220 ohm resistor. Now we will connect this 100E resistor to the breadboard. So connect this resistor 100E anywhere at the breadboard. Now we will make the connection. So first we will connect this input voltage 0 to 20 volt variable power supply to this junction, to this two resistor junction. So connect it here. Like this, and we will connect the ground at this block. Here this is the ground block. Now connect. Now in the circuit we can see that the anode of the Zener diode and the collector of the transistor is grounded. So first we will short these two terminal. So this is base and this is collector. So first short this two terminal. And from this we will connect it to ground. Now the anode and the collector of the transistor is grounded. Now we can see in the circuit that from this junction, that is from the resistor and the cathode of the Zener diode, the base of the transistor is connected. So we are connecting the base of the transistor. Now this is the base of the transistor, so we will connect it to this horizontal line, as this line, horizontal lines are connected with each, internally connected with each other. Now we can see, that from the emitter the current meter is connected. The positive terminal is connected with the emitter and the negative terminal is connected with the 100 ohm resistor. So there is a digital panel meter inbuilt. So we will use this one. So connect the positive terminal of the ammeter
to the emitter of the transistor. So this is the emitter of the transistor, so connect it here and connect the negative terminal to this resistor. Take any terminal of the resistor and connect it to the negative terminal of the current meter. Now from here, from the other terminal of this 100 ohm resistor, we will connect 1k potentiometer. So I am taking this terminal here. Now short this two terminal of the potentiometer, this two terminal. And from this terminal, we will ground this. Now, we will connect a voltmeter, DC voltmeter, so first one is connected, first we are going to connect this voltmeter V2 that is connected across the terminal of this terminal of the resistor, and the negative terminal of the voltmeter is connected to this potentiometer, this terminal of the potentiometer that is grounded. So for this, connect the positive terminal of the voltmeter to this resistor and this terminal of the resistor which is connected with the negative terminal of ammeter, and connect the ground, connect the ground terminal. We will connect this voltmeter V1 across the input power supply. So for this, this is the input power supply. So we have make a connection here. So the power supply is now in this points of the breadboard, so we can connect the positive terminal of the DC voltmeter here, and we will connect the negative terminal of the voltmeter to ground. Now we will check the input voltage and the output voltage, and we will observe how it works as a voltage regulator. Okay, and we will vary this input power supply from 0 to 20 volt. Here we can observe the voltage, and this is the output voltage. We can see that though the input voltage is 20 volt, the output voltage is 6.56. This is the voltage, this voltage is equal to the sum of Zener voltage and voltage of the NPN transistor. Now we are fixing the input voltage around 9 volt. So we have fixed the input voltage around 9 volt. Now varying this load resistor, we will see that the maximum voltage we will get is around 6.3. This is so we can see the voltage is, the maximum voltage is 0 volt. It varies the load resistance. So this is the study of transistor shunt voltage regulator. Our next experiment is 4 to 1 line multiplexer. For this we are going to build this circuit here. So we have taken two 7411 IC, this is 7404 IC, and this one here is 7432 IC. So first we are going to build this connection, that is we are going to give this data input switch to pin number 1. So I am giving this switch to pin number 1. Now from pin number 2 of this IC. It will go to pin number 4. So short these two terminal. After that, again from pin number 2, we will connect pin number 2 of 7404, this one here. From pin number 13, we will connect pin number 11 of this IC, that is this one here. So we will short this two terminal. After that, again from pin number 13, we will connect pin number 4 of 7404. Now, from pin number 12, we will connect pin number 4 of 7432, that is here. Now the connection of this IC1 is almost complete. Now we will take input from this data switch 11 and we will connect this to pin number 3 of IC7411, the first one here. Now we have already connected the fourth pin. Now we will connect the number 5 pin of 7411 to the pin of 7411 IC of second IC, that is this one. Now again from this pin, that is number 5, we will connect pin number 3 of 7404. Now we will take input data from data switch 12 and we will connect this to pin number 9 of 7411. Connect this here. Now from pin number 10, of the first IC, that is 7411, we will connect pin number 4 of the second IC, which is also 7411. Now again from pin number 10, we will connect pin number 1 of 7404. Now from pin number 6 of the first IC, we will connect pin number 5 अब 7432।
नाउ वी विल कनेक्ट
पिन नंबर 8
of the first IC to pin number 2 of 7432. Now the connection of this IC is complete. Now we will do the second one. So connect data switch 13 to the input of data switch 13 to pin number 3 of second IC. Now number 4 is connected, also number 5 is connected of this IC. Now we will connect number 6, pin number 6 of this IC to pin number 1 of 7432. Now we will connect this data switch to pin number 3 of 7404, and we will connect data switch 1 to the pin number 1 of 7404. These are the selector line, so with the help of this line we can select the input line to the output. Now we will connect pin number 3 of 7432 to pin number 13, and
pin number 6 to pin number 12,
and
from pin number 11 we will take the output.
Now we will give power supply, so connect plus 5 volt here and connect ground here. Now we will connect
pin number 14 to all IC to the power supply block so connect all the IC
the power supply
and connect pin number 7 to the ground block.
Now we will observe the output. Turn on the gate. Now with the help of these two selection line, we will select the input line in output. So when both are 1 1, the input line 10 is selected. We can see the output is according to the input. Now when I am selecting 0 1, then this input 12 is selected. Like this, you can check the rest of them and verify the truth table that is given in the manual.